Let's talk about Ohio.
Mm-hmm. There were two school districts in Ohio that have been accused of scrubbing the lowest test scores for their students, and in doing so, receive an A on their overall evaluation rather than the C that they should have gotten, and received $28,000 worth of a $28,000 bonus from the state for receiving those good scores that they didn't actually get.
Okay, you use the term scrubbing, as did the Columbus Dispatch I see here. Data scrubbing. What does that mean exactly?
It means basically the lowest grades weren't counted.
Oh, I see. So the if you're the kid who doesn't you're not the smartest kids, then they kind of like, well, we don't want to include that in the list, and so they have this I wanted to talk about a little bit of this too, because as you mentioned, $28,000 was the penalty for I've forgotten.
It was the bonus they received for getting an A.
It's the Northridge, near Dayton, Ohio, the Northridge School District, which I looked it up, has a grand total of one high school. And you know,
Northridge and Campbell.
Okay, so they received a $28,000 bonus, which they will now lose because they cheated, essentially.
Right.
And so, look, I mean, this is like a whole school district loses $28,000. What is this? You know, maybe half to a third of one teacher's average teacher's salary, you know, that the whole district is going to lose. Like, this is in the weeds, right? This is a grain of sand on the beach in terms of the penalty this district will see. And as I was asserting earlier, Jason, if you, one can imagine if a charter school did this, you know, this would be in the story we're about to hear in a second, actually, from Chris. Mm-hmm. It would be considered, you know, oh, we got to seriously consider yanking the entire charter from the school, and the whole school could go out of business for something like this, right? I mean, seriously, the whole charters have been eliminated for charter schools for doing exactly this kind of thing. What's the penalty for the Northridge, venerable Northridge, Ohio school district? I don't know, 40% of one teacher's salary for an entire district gets no longer granted to them that one year. That's their penalty. So I see a bit of a disconnect, to borrow a James Schulz's term, in this regard. Your turn.
Yeah, well, I think that, certainly, you know, this has been an ongoing issue probably for about the last 2 years since it first came to light that the districts were basically going in and withdrawing these students once they received the test grades back, and then re-enrolling the students without their knowledge, and they had no paperwork to back this up, simply so that they could have their testing data removed and presumably then boost the grade that they were receiving on their state report card.
So let me, it says here six districts that altered data in the 2010-11 school year will get new report cards, including notably Cincinnati and Cleveland. I guess you're two of your biggest, if not your biggest districts. But mm-hmm. nevertheless, that's six districts, and it says new report cards being issued for 143 schools. Has it been huge news in Ohio? Has it been a big deal?
Oh, it definitely has been a big deal, particularly here where we're based here in Columbus, really is where the scandal sort of originated. And they're actually, not only are they looking at the changes in the grade card and possible forfeiture of any bonuses that any buildings may have received for those grades, but there's also the possibility of criminal prosecution that could be going on as a result of those changes.
Right.
The state auditor just recently came out with a report within the last 2 months about it. It's been a very big deal.
Okay.
And I think that you're absolutely right that it definitely illustrates a disconnect that about the treatment that charters, private schools who accept vouchers receive versus the criticism that public schools get or rather don't get when these issues come to light.
Right. And I guess it's fair to say I'm being flippant about the lack of consequences to these schools when I'm making light of the 28 grand for the one district, because individual people might actually be charged criminally. So I guess my argument remains that it's the districts themselves won't see a major penalty. It might just be individuals involved. So but that's a worthy point to make.